Cell allows you to automate some tedious tasks using something called the macro recorder. Now just here to set the example, what we've got is some information from years 1 to 10. You'll see it's 100 to 1000. What we want to do is next year what will happen is this 1000 must fall off and this 100 to 900 is move one down, so we've got space to enter the new information. How we can do that is to use the macro recorder, and you'll see it's recorded under the view tab. At the end here we've got macros, and you'll see the options are view macros, record macros, and use relative references. So let's now record a macro. I'm going to click on record macro. You'll see you get some options, so I'm going to name it. So I'm just going to call this rolling years. Quite important, you can't have spaces in the name. You can give it a shortcut key if you want. You can tell it where to store the macro, which is quite important. It can either be in the Personal Macro Workbook, which is a workbook that exists and opens every time you open Excel. You can store it in a new workbook, or else in this workbook. So I'm going to store it in this workbook. And if you want, you can give it a bit of a description. When I click OK, you'll see at the bottom here, there's a little button here, and it warns you, a macro is currently recording. When you're going to stop, you'll stop it there. But now any keystrokes you type will be recorded. So for example, what I'm going to do here is I want this to roll down. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to say, please click on that cell, and I'm going to delete it. And I want you to come up here, grab those cells. I'm going to copy it. I'm going to move it one down. Paste it. And then I'm going to remove the top one. Delete, and I'm going to leave it in here so that when they run the macro, I'm immediately able to capture here. I'm going to push stop. Okay. Now let's see how well our macro works. Again, under view for macros, I'm going to go to view macros. And you'll see, I can see here, because I've said show me the macros only in this workbook, it says rolling years. Let's watch what it does. When I click on it and say run, just watch what happens here. You'll see it's quickly run through, deleted the bottom, taken the top, copied it down, put it in here. So we can now, if we want to, let's say put a, I don't know, 50 and a 75 here. The next year we go view macros, rolling years, click run. And you'll see it's moved down, and slowly but surely it rolls all the way down. Now I just want to show you what the recorder did while you were recording. So if you go to macros and you go to view macros, when we go to rolling years, I'm going to edit it. When I click the edit button, you'll see it takes me to the VBA editor. And while you were recording the keystrokes, Excel was actually writing code. So you'll see says here, range, choose cell D1, clear the contents, choose a range, copy it, paste it, etc. So what it's done is taken your actions and turned it into code it can understand. Also, another useful ability in Excel is once you have set up a macro, you can actually set up a button or a picture or something that you can automatically activate the macro. So for example, I'm going to go to insert here. I'm just going to insert a shape. So let's use this over here. Top here, I'm going to put a picture there. And what you can do is if you right click on any shape or picture, you'll see an option here exists saying assign macro. When I click assign macro, you'll see it gives me all the macros that are available. I'm going to say please assign this one, rolling years, and say OK. And you can make that neat and tidier and put words in it or whatever. Just clicking away from it. Now, when I want to run the macro, here's the list. You go here, you'll see I'll click, and it'll run. I can click and run, and you can see you can use your macro very easily.